And now, it's Cooking with Kyle.
Hello, and welcome to Cooking with Kyle. Kaylee would be in this video, but she's being shy, and she won't be in the video, so... this is inspired by Corey. Corey, you know who you are. And, we're gonna make some lunch today. Some homemade buffalo chicken and, french fries. Homemade. We are in my home, so... wearing my I'm Skinny Let's Party shirt. Why not, you know? Not skinny, but let's party! First things first, we've got to get the pots and pans. No, we don't need pots. First, we gotta get the pan. We'll get two small, so they'll fit in the oven this way. And let's get our ingredients. And our ingredients are... buffalo chicken. If you don't live in the South and you don't know what Publix is, move down to the South and shop at Publix. Best freaking grocery store in the world. And let's see. Turtle cup with ice or french fries. Let's go with french fries. And once again, Publix brand. Seasoned. And we'll go ahead and fix the rest of the great value fries. And we have a special request from one of our diners. She would like regular chicken nuggets. So, here's the chicken nuggets. So step one is open everything with one hand. Alright, go ahead and put a handful of those on there for her, get hers out of the way, put the fries on one, and get this open. We'll see if there's a difference between the Publix and the Walmart sides and everything. They're both seasoned fries. Here's the Walmart. Oh yeah, big difference. If you look here at the Walmart fry, it's a little smaller, a little scrawnier. But I wouldn't expect less from Walmart. That's enough for two. Oh, you know what would help? It's if I turn the oven on. Let's see, and I think it's 425. Yep, 425. So one of the things that I do to most of my chicken is I like my chicken, like buffalo chicken, like really wet, like a lot of sauce. So, down here we have a restaurant chain called Beef O'Brady's. It's like a sports pub. And their sauce is always really good. It's like some kind of special mix and ingredient. It's not just regular buffalo sauce. And what I've done is I've found out what they put in it for a majority of the sauce. They add tomato sauce out of the can, I guess, and a little bit of garlic. So that's what I've done. I added about half the bottle of crystal sauce, half the bottle of tomato sauce, and some garlic salt. So what we're gonna do with my chicken is, I'm trying to do this with one hand, bear with me. It's already buffaloed up, but I'm going to put some buffalo sauce in the bag and shake it up. So here we go. Nope, not enough. Nope, keep going. Still not enough. Okay, maybe that's good. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Alright. So, here's the sauce and the chicken. I gotta zip this up so I can shake it without it spilling everywhere. Grab the top with a big old bag full of air and chicken and buffalo sauce. And just kind of mix it up. Now, you know what I should do? I should line the pan with aluminum foil so it doesn't stick. This is gonna be fun. This is, I'm gonna set the camera down for this one. It's gonna make a little aluminum barrier for my chicken. We can do this. Let's try it. Aluminum foil on one side. And I've made a little barrier wall here. So the sauce, A, doesn't run into her chicken, and B, doesn't stick to the pan. Because it's easy to just to wipe off the stuff from the regular chicken nuggets and fries, but that sauce will be a pain in the butt to scrub off of that pan. Watch the goodness. Watch the goodness. Oh my goodness. Oh, it's so good. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. I am so fat. But you know what? I'm happy. So whatever. So we're going to go ahead and put the fries in. They always take longer. So fries are in, because it's only at, what's here for the click? Oh, it's only at 250, so we will keep heating. So we're gonna get my plates ready. Oh, look at that cute guy. Who's that? That's me. Let's see. I got some special plates just for today. Not just for today, but it'll work really good for this special edition. One for her. One for me. Turtles in a half shell. Turtle power. Waiting on the fries. Let's go grab a drink. So we've got Capri Sun, A&W root beer, Sun Drop, coffee creamer, Budweiser. We got one Budweiser left, but it's only 11 o'clock in the morning. I don't want V8, so we're gonna have to go with Sun Drop. Ghetto Mountain Dew. Good stuff. Something I didn't do that I do a lot is I forget to put the timer on. So we're going to do the fries for 6 minutes. Start. All right. So 6 minutes for the fries before we put the chicken in. All right. So now we're going to add the chicken. Let's do this. Ooh, hot. Hot. So good, so good. Not Mountain Dew, but it's good. Close second. Listen, you can hear the food cooking. Listen. This is how you know you're fat. When you have this many snacks. Well, half of them are for the kids, but prepare for this. Wise makes these things called cheese waffies. It's just what you think it is. Waffle crackers with cheese. And they are so good. Like, you know, Ritz has their little, what are they called? Cheese, like the crackers with cheese in them, Ritz bits or something like that. But these are little waffles. Listen. So, so good. All right. Got 3 minutes, 37 seconds. So I had to take the fries out. Some of them are starting to burn. So I think that means they're done. And I think we can go ahead and take the chicken out. It's got less than a minute left, so let's do that. Oh yeah. Looking good. Yum. Homemade. Homemade buffalo chicken chunks, chicken nuggets, and fries. Let's get it plated up. Alright, there you have it. Homemade, because I made it at home. Buffalo chicken chunks and fries. And chicken nuggets and fries. I'm going to have some blue cheese with my fries and wings. She's going to have some McDonald's sweet and sour sauce. Let me taste it. Let's see how it tastes. Putting that extra buffalo sauce makes it a lot better. The fries are a little dark, but
hey,
that means just a little crispier, right? Alrighty, guys. Thanks for watching. And as always, like, comment, subscribe down below. And y'all have a good one.
This concludes Cooking with Kyle.